Well, hello, guys and girls and gentlemen and women, ladies. And just everybody, welcome to my channel. I am going to make a mail card this time. Not like mail that you put in the mail. A mail, like a guy card. I took some Cricut vinyl and Cricut foil, and I created some gears in the Cricut. And so I cut them out. And so I'm gonna use those. So I got these gears here. So we're gonna use those. And I'm gonna take a circle punch, which my circle punches are supposed to be right here. Oh, of course not, Linda. Oh. Because that's what they're supposed to be doing. Where did they go? Where did my circle punches go? Oh, wait. Maybe they're here. Here they are. Okay. So let's find the circle gear. The circle die that fits the gears. Let's see. This one too big. I think that's about right. Maybe a little smaller. Let's see. The next size I think is just too small. Oh, I think maybe that'll be too small. We'll have to do this size. I don't know what size it is. I just know it's that size out of the nesting dies. It's the third size up. Because out of these stitch dies. Come on, little circle. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut out some circles for my gears to go on. Out of cardstock. Let's put this paper over here. So, let's do that first. Let's get our circles made. Put all this aside. Just, whoop, out of the way. Alright. So, I need to make 1, 2, 3, well, maybe. That one's not going to be big enough for that one. But it'd be big enough for these. Okay, what did I just do with those again? Decided that this one would fit this, right? All right, and what about this one? Yeah. So I need two of those, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some glitter tape, tape it down. Two on that, and then we're going to write one for that. I'll just take some tape I got over here, and we'll tape that down, and then this one, which I think. That'll be perfect. So we need two of these. since I need two like that, I'm going to take, and I'm going to cut my paper here. And this has got paper stuck in it again. And I'm going to double this up. And I should be able to get cut through two papers. Here's one cutting plate. And because we're doing two different papers here, I'm going to kind of tape that down to the paper. Just going to tape it to this so as I'm moving things around, I don't lose it. I don't lose where it goes. So there we go. Go. Now I have the Big Shot Plus, and I think they're considered extended plates and platform that came with it. So I'm just going to run this through my Big Shot. Which is a manual die cutting machine. Roll that. It's got a handle, and I just roll it through. And usually I hear crunching and cracking and all that, but I'm not hearing it, so we're going to do that once. And I'm going to do it one more time, go through, and then come back, because I'm doing two papers, and I hate to open it up and then find out later it didn't cut all the way, so I just go ahead and double it every time I do it. Go. Did more than one, like I said. So we got it. This doesn't usually stick to my, there we go. Alright. I'm just gonna pop those out. Eyes back in there and put them back over here where they belong with that little magnet thing I got going on. And then we're gonna move all that out of the way. And then I'm going to go, okay, this goes to these. This goes to these, and this goes to this one. So what I'm going to do, is I'm going to take my gear off. See, now normally with vinyls and stuff, you would use transfer tape, but I'm doing it like a sticker, so I'm not doing a transfer tape. Don't tell me it didn't cut all. Okay, there we go. So let's lay this flat so we can do this. There we go. Oh, that's way too big. Way too big. That's alright. That's okay. This is what we're going to do. We're going to take some vellum. And we're just going to stick this onto some vellum. And I'm just going to cut around the vellum. Let's take that back off the vellum. Yeah, I kind of messed up my sizes, so I'm kind of like, let's do something different. I wanted to make them so they popped up a little, but anyway. Let's stick that there for a second. I'm going to take this vellum and I'm going to measure it out, and I'm going to do it at 4 inches. By 5 1/4. Big gear right there. And maybe these circles turned out the right size. Let's see. Got two of them. There's one gear. And I made them all different gears, I do believe. If they're not different, they're different sizes. And then we'll put that one on there. Because I put it there. Set that aside for a minute. Let's do a little inking. don't want no white. No, I don't want no white. I don't want any white on there. So, let's get rid of the white. Now, let's put our gear on it. Lay that like that. Then we got our big one. Nope. Or the other one, like this Galinda. Oh, I laid it down already. Okay. So then, yeah. Is not my weeding tool. I had it laid out ready to use. There it is. Oh, don't tell me my Cricut didn't cut it all the way through. Come on. Come on. Okay. What's up with you? I probably put it on the wrong setting. So it probably did not cut all the way because I probably put it on the wrong setting. Yep. It didn't. And I'm going to mess it up. So I'm just not going to do that. I don't want to mess it up, but I want these. Well, this sucks. It didn't cut all the way through because I didn't put it on the correct setting. That's why. Which means... I gotta play with it. And I'm trying to do this where I don't waste any of my vinyl. Don't want to rip my gear. Don't rip my gear, man. Don't rip my gear. I should double check this, I guess, before I did the video, but I wanted to see you guys see that I did this with Cricut cutting and the best I could without. Look at that. Alright, where's the scissors? I don't like that gear because it's all messed up. So, I don't like it. It's all messed up. It almost looks like a Chinese star, not a gear. Let's just stick this over here. Because we're going to move on to something different. Three gears will be... Oh, we don't have to do three gears. Hang on. Let's see. Let's try something here. I'm trying to be slick here. We'll just do this like a stencil. And we'll take our, do my fletchy. We'll create our own gear. I don't think Memento was really meant to do this with, but we're doing it anyway. There we go. And we got us a gear. Color I'm looking for or not. Let's try and see. Whether it looks cool or not, I don't know. But I'm going to keep playing with it till I like it. let's see what other colors I have. These are all bright and cheery. We don't want those. Even though the card is going to be cheery, it's just not going to be spring color cheery. I thought I had espresso or smoke, but I'm not seeing any of those colors. So let's try weathered wood. Let's see what happens. There we go. That's going to get darker, at least. Not the color I'm looking for, though. It's making it too green. I don't want green. Hmm. Feathered wood and old paper make green. Certainly need that one, do we? No, I am not doing this the way it's supposed to be done, but I don't follow instructions well when I'm being creative. When I'm cooking, I follow instructions great. When I'm doing other things, I follow instructions great. Well, sometimes, depending on where my brain is. But when I'm creating, my brain says, no rules, no rules, just do it. We're doing that to get it off of the chrome if it's on. Let's see what we got. There we go. You know what? Let's do this. Let's just try this just to see what happens. Let's just go like this. Better, seeing how that is where we stamped it from, right? I know a lot of people are probably like, what is she doing? What is she doing? She's doing icky, dumb things, but this is what I'm doing. I'm not lining it up, that's what I'm doing. Should line it perfectly, seeing how this is my stencil, isn't it? Wasn't it my stencil? Pretty sure it was. It should line up just right. It's not lining up. Maybe it's not lining up because maybe I'm leaving it. Just gonna add some glue for safe measure. By the way, this is the first one, and any of you that know the first time you're doing something, it's usually the one you make most mistakes on. So for the car guy, for Father's Day, the basic idea of this card is a really good one. The execution could be a lot smoother. And these are Stampin' Up! Stamps, if you didn't read that. I don't know why I'm putting this in here. I don't know why I'm doing that. Let's just set that aside over there. There we go. Let's do this. We're doing this on this so we don't waste this. Oh. Do we want it to say Happy Father's Day? Or something else? Let's see. Yeah, we're going to stick it with Father's Day. I don't know why I didn't get one that said Mother's Day, but I didn't. Kind of weird seems how I'm not a father, but I'm a mother. Guess what? That's the wrong side, because you know what? This is a rubber stamp, so I have to flip this over. We want it to be a different color, so we don't want it to just be straight up like that. Let's do blueprint sketch and see how that looks. Oh, there's part of my mom word. feel like I'm getting better at this blending. Even though I'm still learning. But, like, how to get it across onto the paper. I don't know why that paper's all cut up like that. But it is. Okay. I'm probably going to mess this up, and I'll have to restamp my sentiment, and that'll be okay, but I want to try something. That's not it. And that will tie in the gold gear, right? Pretty easy card. A little overthinking made it a little more complicated than it needed to be. On my part. No, I can't. Excuse my head for a second, but I can't move this once I do this, so it's gotta. There we go. sorry, guys. I just got into this card making and just quit talking. Okay. I'm looking for my dimensionals that I just had when I was making another card, a Mom's Day card earlier. Which is right here. My Mom's Day card that I was making earlier. And I got a little carried away with all the stuff. But maybe my dimensionals are with that, but I don't see them, so no. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to use some of Brutus Monroe foam tape. And there is no doubt in my mind that this will pop it up and give it some dimension. And if you wanted to get real fancy, you could run, you can emboss like the vellum or emboss whatever you're using. I use the vellum because, like, to give the card and the chrome and stuff, the adhesive foils, to give the card a sparkle without girlifying it or making it feminine. I wanted it to be masculine. And to me, that's masculine. What do y'all think? I think my happy Father's Day needs help. That's what I think. Let's see what we can do here. I really wish I had glitter glaze, but I don't, so let's just so this is Nouveau Drops, Crystal Nouveau Drops. I don't have Wink of Stella or anything like that, or I would use that. But I don't have it, so I'm using this. Because I just think my card needs just a little something to make it oomph. I think that works. Alright guys, that's a Father's Day card. And then I just need to add the card base to it. Which, yeah, we can do that real quick. So I'm just gonna take this dark color. And we're gonna try to hope that A2 is a 5.5, which that's 5.5. We're gonna make it a little bit bigger. 5.5, we're gonna do it like that. 5 3/4, it's not gonna be an A2 card. It's gonna be some other size. And then instead of 4 1/4, we're just going to go, is that maybe 4.5? Now, I don't know why it's not wanting to cut properly. Oh, I see why. Because from that one little cut that we've done, there's paper in there, and my blade. Probably need to change my blade. It's getting a little untrustworthy. I don't know why my blade is wanting to tear up all my papers. I don't get it. I gotta cut fine 1 minute and then won't cut fine the next. I wasn't supposed to cut this anyway. I was supposed to fold it. Ba 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 ba. I didn't do it big enough. By the time we get done, it's going to be a 6 by something measurements. I am like overdue for coffee. I think that's why I'm getting super quiet also. Just like, oh, okay. I'm gonna do this without tearing my paper up because I don't understand why this is doing that. I stink at cutting straight lines. Oh my goodness, do I stink at it. We could have done so many different little things. I could have put letter tape across and put this on that. I could have put, like, paper going across and, yeah, but whatever. It is what it is, man. And I gotta find my gray smoke because I gotta go around this. There, I like that. I like that better than just that brown by itself like that. Oh, my Nuvo stuff's gonna dry. I always do that. That's why I don't use Nuvo drops half time, because look, I just smudged it. Oh, come on, I know it. Didn't dry up that damn fast. It looks like it did. Here we go, guys. This is just an example. This is not going to be the card base. Well, actually, it could be, because I can do that and then cut it down, because I don't really know what size it needs to be. So, let's do that. Stop putting your fingers in it, Linda. If my trimmer worked, I would just measure this and do it with my trimmer. But I need blades, apparently. Apparently need blades. There we go. Well, I'm going over the edges with ink so that way you don't have any white peering through from where it was cut and stuff. I think I got it all. I think I got it. Oh no, don't do that one. Okay. I think we got it, guys. I think we have a card. I think I'm happy with it, even though I had a few mishaps, like my crystal drops, which I always seem to do this. Always seem to, that's crazy. Okay, I didn't want that line like that. Shouldn't show the smudge so bad then. Because that pee is puffy, like. Because the pee is puffy. Alright, guys. Aside from a couple of little flaws, there's a Happy Father's Day card using Stampin' Up! Geared Up! Garage Cricut vinyl adhesive foil. And I don't know what. They're just a off-brand set of stitch circles that I got. I believe I got them on Amazon. And the vellum is Cricut. The craft card stock was Stampin' Up. And then this card stock was just a cheap card stock from Michaels. And that's how I made my Father's Day card for 2019. All right, guys. Have a great day. Hit subscribe. Hit share. Hit like. If you stay to the end, thank you. Guys, we are almost at 100. We are just like 6 subscriptions away. Boop, 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 boop. All right, bye. Bye. I keep saying goodbye and I'm still here because I can't get up. Okay, bye. We'll try that again. Bye.